Hello and welcome to, is it a good idea to microwave this t-shirt design contest results show?
That's a lot of words.
I know, isn't it? I'm your host, Jonathan Paula.
And I'm Jory Karen.
As you might have seen last week, we kicked off our first ever t-shirt design contest and over 95 of you submitted great designs to us.
That's just shy of 4 million.
Just shy.
Almost there.
Alright, so let's take a look at some of our favorite 15 entries.
Our fave 15.
We'll take a look at the whole pool a little later on. So our first entry comes to us from Alyssa Papp. It came from the microwave.
It came from the Papp.
Alyssa Papp, you're right, Jerry. Very good. Pretty good text design here in the middle. It definitely gives the message of the show across. Our next entry comes from Amber Steery.
And we're going to go ahead and steer clear of this one.
As you can see, she's still clearly in elementary school. The word safety is missing a crucial vowel, and without it, safety first, number one concern.
Also, if you look really closely here, it's stoop ed, almost like retard ed.
Now, Jory, here's a quick question. I guess only Amber Steery can answer. What is that brown donut object growing out of your face? But otherwise, a solid effort, Amber.
Next, we have this lovely drawing by Anthony LoPrimo. I feel like one day right before I die because I do an experiment that's way over the top and my life will flash before my eyes, this is what I'll see. Sort of a disco rendition of microwaving shit.
Alright, let's move along. This next one is sent in from Christina, no last name provided. And as you can see, there's good reason for that. She doesn't want to be associated with this entry once it went out the email box. So, sorry Christina, no last name provided, but not today. Oh.
The next entry is actually provided by a Danila Kaparos.
I kind of like where the person was going with this. Clearly, nitroglycerin, not a good idea to microwave. You didn't need me and Jory to tell you that much.
I think this bad idea is in fact a good idea.
Let's take this one here from Dustin McLaughlin.
Now, maybe you're not getting the full perspective here.
This is a shirt.
Imagine these arrows are right here.
I know, right? Very clever wordplay with this, clearly referring to the pectorals of a man's bosom.
Yes. I like the direction this one is going.
Definitely going up and towards the chesticles.
Well, the next one is provided by a Edith Gutierrez.
There's a whole lot going on, and a lot of it's really dark and really red. And the font
kind of like your soul.
A little bit. And the font choice is kind of all over the place. But otherwise, I really like what he's done here. He's put a lot of work into it, and it really shows. And moving on to this one from James Logging Naughty, sorry if I got that wrong. He actually hand-drew this one, no computers involved, and I really like Jory. He's kind of grouped the experiments with each microwave.
The problem here is we've never done that, and I'm really grossed out by what glue is doing to Sandra.
Thanks, James. Let's take a look at another one.
The next one is provided by a Mario Oklahoma.
Now, I really like this one. It's kind of play on our existing logo, and he's hand-drawn it with some bubbles and some smoke effects, and
I do really enjoy this one, I must say.
Okay, the next one sent in by mcmguitarist@hotmail.com. Now, you can tell he didn't really put a lot of work into this one. I'm pretty sure he just kind of threw this up in about 4 or 5 minutes. And it says I pwn, and so does JP.
I pwn noobs every Monday and Friday because I am leet. And the next one is provided by a Rosina Ramirez.
I really like this one. It's an MS Paint version of what happens regularly on her show. Lacey devouring you whole.
She has eaten my whole.
You are funny. Let's take a look at the next one. This sent in by Sam, no last name provided. Now this one's pretty simple, but I still really like it.
We don't need a match to light something on fire.
I think that's a pretty catchy slogan. It might work on a t-shirt or maybe even a bumper sticker. Definitely has some promise. I like where this one is going. Next up, this one in from Sean Seferin. Again, with the cartoon kind of feel, which has been prominent in all of our entries.
Are all of these images clip art?
I still kind of like what he's done with it. He's given us cartoon representations of all the different experiments we've done on the show. Well, thanks for your entry, Sean. Next up, this one from Steffen Kopp. Now, this one's pretty solid, Jory.
I do like this one.
Definitely used a lot of different layers and typefaces and good use of depth and shadows. It's a new take on the old and busted logo we're wearing on our shirts. Will it replace it?
It's true.
Only your votes will tell.
And one last t-shirt design is from the T-Man 432.
I wonder what he was thinking when he sent this in. As you can tell from the incredibly subpar quality, I was literally emailed a thumbnail. I can tell you right now, it's not going to win. But thanks for submitting. All right, well, those were our favorite 15 submissions. Now let's take a look at all the other ones that didn't quite make it into this video.
Just in, now, the top five.
All right, let's take a look at letter A, this one sent in by Anthony LoPrimo. If you liked his, then leave a text for A below. Dustin McLaughlin, leave a text below for B if you liked Dustin's entry. Edith Gutierrez, if you liked Edith's design, then leave a text below for letter C. Rosina Ramirez, if you liked Rosina's design, then leave a text below for letter D. Steffen Kopp, if you liked Steffen's design, leave a text below for letter E. All right, so those were your top five entries for the 2008 Is It a Good Idea to Microwave This T-Shirt Design Contest. Leave a text below for who you think is the best. The voting is now open. All right, we'll see you next time on the T-Shirt Design Results Show. Bye.